Thank you. Te dionanță de calcut omoi. Hai arată să-mi cu aburile putoscă. Te dau cup cu omoi. Esei să-ți nofer cearolona, cearăs-o carpul dumnei. Te dau cup cu omoi. La ciora poza a la cara să te bag pe rau te șeru.
Thank you. backstage with the shoot for the tribal superstars. We're going to go around asking about jewelry, some clothes, a little costuming, so everybody gets their influence. So, come on.
Hi, look. Lovely. Hi, how are you doing?
Good.
Good, good. Tell us about your outfit. Where did all this concept come from?
Okay, this is from Thailand. A girlfriend of ours, Melodia, loaned them to us and created sort of a traditional Thai apron shape. And these are from India, and just kind of bunched it all together. And this is from Indonesia.
Okay.
So it's a Thai fusion piece.
Nice.
And then we got these from the bead store and just made them.
You made this?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's great. Look at that. Oh, it looks so good against your skin. Pretty, yeah. Pretty. And then I remember during rehearsal week, Cammie was gluing these bits on there. So
yeah,
these are handmade by Cammie Little.
Herself. Fun.
Yeah, fun, fun.
Oh boy.
Close up, hot body. And then these earrings, these are bone earrings.
Mm-hmm.
And they, okay, get a close up on this. This is great. So these, she doesn't have her ears stretched. They're just looped over her lobe with a post going through. So it gives the effect of this really big stretched ear, but is actually
without the stretched ear.
Without the stretched ear, yeah.
Brilliant.
And tell us about your makeup.
Well, it's definitely packed on there.
Yeah.
I put like a shimmer gold base on there so it has an overall tone of gold, and then I just put like black over that.
Okay, and close your eyes. Let's get a close up of that. That pretty, pretty girl. Cat eyes. Tell us about your lovely flowers that we can never get our hands on.
It's an experiment. I hope it works.
Yeah, it looks great. So you're saying that you got these from a place you used to work that was like interior design or a specialty store?
Well, I did work with plants, and sometimes we did work with a business. Thank you. Anyway, they do really good silks, and so they're rubber, even though they look kind of real.
Yeah, and they're floppy. That's what I love about them. They're floppy. And so how do you get all of this to stay on for you? How do you make it? Tie it on with ribbons up here?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's mainly built off of headbands and then tied so that the weight is evenly distributed. It's actually just a way to hold these without just having like a strap across my hip.
Like elastic or something.
Yeah.
So what are those?
These are Turkmen earrings.
Beautiful. And where did you get those?
These were a gift from a friend of mine who is Iranian, who got them in a flea market in Tehran.
Nice. Very nice. Well, thank you. You look lovely.
Well, thank you.
Yeah. Alrighty, so let's come over here and talk with Zoe. She's preparing for her next shoot. Hi, Zoe. How are you?
Half of the job of being a tribal dancer is collecting. It's really fun. And really is, you're like, ooh, I'm going to buy that, and I need it to dance.
I need it.
Need it. It's a heart. I love hearts. See, this is a heart from Indonesia as well.
Ooh.
And this is a suit from Egypt, and I believe that's the name of the town where it's made, which, and I believe they started making it in the 20s or something like that.
Mm-hmm. And this is actual bits of metal, right?
That yeah, it's bits of silver.
Okay.
That they pound. It's like tin and silver, and they pound it into the fabric. It's like a metal weave fabric.
We are going to say something about this.
Oh. And this was fabric that we got at the Fashion District when me and Mariah went to the Fabric District.
We had a Zomo Day.
And these are fake nails.
Oh, lovely. I haven't seen those before.
I hate them.
I hate them too.
I did
hate them so much. I love them.
Only for the shoot. I feel like an animal that has caps on its nails. I'm like, I can't do anything right now.
Putting on your makeup.
Yeah. Yeah. So, okay, and these are from India. These giant bindis. Ooh.
Gorgeous.
And these guys are from China.
Mm-hmm.
The Dong tribe. Where the heck are
they? This one, the pin.
This guy, this is actually Javanese. It's from Indonesia. That's the thing about this stuff is it doesn't look like a lot. And I'm glad that I'm only wearing half my costume. But every costume has little bits. And this is $10, and this is $20, and this was $80. And it's ridiculous.
And this is $500, which is a good price.
Oh, yeah, yeah. This was a $500 belt. It is solid silver from Rajasthan.
Lovely. I love it. I love it.
Yeah. These pants are, it's a funny story. Okay. These pants, my friend Desiree from a company called Nomadia made these, and they were pants, full pants. And then the butt kept blowing out, meaning that they were ripping in the butt area. So what I did was I cut them off, discarded the top part of the pants, and made them into these little boots.
Hey.
And they look like little boots.
They're
so cute.
Yeah. Okay, and then tell us just a minute about your inspiration for your look. Like, I remember we were talking about when you cut these, sort of an Aeon Flux look.
Mm, these are like Aeon Fluxy, and let's see what else.
Like, who do you think are your influences, kind of?
Burlesque is a big, big, big influence for me. And another big influence for me is definitely, like, the older style, like, in the 20s and stuff.
Yeah.
And something, too, is kind of this, like, I guess you could say goth, but I want to say more, like...
Antique?
Not even antique, but, like the late 1800s, like, that style,
yeah, right,
with, like, the dark and the dark eyes and the macabre style. I get a lot of my... aesthetic from that, for sure.
So let me just get you a little eyelash here, love.
Oh, let me blow it off. Let me blow it off.
Oh. Good job. This is a huge piece of estuite that's Zoe's, and what I love about this one is the color. It's not specific. I mean, it's not black, it's not brown, it's not gray, and you can see the little bits of metal that have been sort of woven together and then punched in there. So it's really lovely. It's all silver. She's gorgeous. And here's this plain Zoe's jewelry. Look at these monsters. And these things weigh a ton. I mean, our arms are getting the biggest workout during the dance, I think, because these things are just so heavy. And then these things come from, like, antique stores and can even be more of a modern vibe, so sort of mixing things together. Sort of a Mooka-esque aesthetic. Let's go back to the makeup room and see what's going on back here. So here we have Ms. Heather Stant, the infamous
Heather.
We love her from Urban Tribal in San Diego, and she's busy on her cell phone. We're going to interrupt her.
Like crackberry.
Crackberry, yeah, yeah. So tell us a little bit about your look, because you're, you know, tribal, but not in all the jewelry and not all the coin bras and all of that. So where did you pull all that from?
Simple.
Yeah.
I like to be simple and comfortable, and I'm not into big ornamentation.
Mm-hmm. And is that just from, like, flow of dance movements?
Yes.
Or,
Yes. I think it suits our style.
Right. You have a lot of, like, long limbs, streamlined sort of shapes that you're creating on stage.
Yeah, I think it suits us.
Come on, back here we have the infamous Rachel Bryce.
The infamous? What do you mean?
No, Miss Rachel, how are you doing?
I'm next.
She's next, so we're not going to bug her too much, but we'll just maybe pan up and down this lovely costume of hers. Tell us a little bit about your influence and what you kind of create when you're creating your shapes. You've got sort of a Princess Leia vibe going on here.
Yeah, I'm definitely inspired by Star Wars and comic books.
And Sasha Higby
and Shasha.
Mooka.
And Mooka, that's a huge inspiration.
Yeah.
I have some Chinese coins, and then... These are from Ethiopia, these are from Afghanistan, this is Amazonite. I think Amazonite comes from Africa. These are Moroccan earrings that broke, so they got to live again. Vintage, old brooch. I don't know where these are from. These are from Africa someplace. This is a good story. This is a Tuareg hair pendant. And these come from a python that Marty, actually, the animal died of natural causes, and she purchased the python's spine from her previous owners. So, and then these are Turkmen here. And then this is, you know, a good old fabulous eBay find of 20s deco shoe clip. And then these are the only... Well, that's not true. There's other organic stuff. This is plant life. This is actually called, it's a devil's claw seed pod. And this is probably English. I don't know. Old jet from eBay. Everything is like, oh, all of this stuff, it's all from eBay.
Yeah. Pretty much. So here we are in my neck of the woods. This is my little bag. And I guess one of the most asked about pieces that I have is my headdress here. And you'll see it on the performance DVD, but what I've done is I took an Indian necklace and sewed it onto a base, then put rhinestones along the top, and then took this off of an Indian necklace actually that I'm wearing a full piece of. And when I bought it, it came with about double as much stuff. That was huge. It hung down to my abdomen, and I cut it up, put some different pieces in different places. So when I wear it, it's got all these little clips on the back, and I slide it right on and then can clip the pieces here so it stays. And then I've got the drapes of coins that I strung and put on there. This is horsehair and tassels. So it sort of just all goes on, flips on, and then I do the hair. And I'll use little flower bits, little rubber flowers, and these are Sharon's. She let me borrow them for the shoot. Little shells and things put on there. And then I made this belt with kind of a blue design in mind. These are just shells, bits of shells I took apart, put together. Little coins, an Uzbeki tassel belt, you know, just bits of things all strung in there. These were just old jazz pants that I cut the waist off of and then shredded fabric and started sewing it all on and around the knees and down the bottom of it. And when Zoe and I went on our Zomo shopping day in the fashion district, or fabric district downtown, we got this ruffle material that I sewed all on there. So it just texturized a pair of plain old black pants.